course, that would be successfully reduced to the events. However, whether this interleukotherapy is accompanied with this morphological change in human remain a question and a hypothesis in a few morphological studies. Therefore, together with Dr. Marita Crispi in Sweden, we're looking into this question. She recruited a patient with symptomatic greater than 70% lower than standard patient in this study. Other patients received pharmaceutical treatment for 3 months. Other patients received nothing, no lithotherapy. And prior to the schedule of surgery, during the surgery, she collected an histological study of this. As we can see, pharmaceutical treatment significantly reduced the lipid content in the blood, which is also accompanied by reduce some oxidized LDL immune reactivity. We also look into the inflammatory cell infiltration. This is a decrease of T cell macrophage in the plaque from patient treated with pharmaceutical treatment. The cell death has assessed by tonal staining also reduced. The collagen content also significantly increased, and this is a representative feature of the pseudoscedulous staining. In a smaller study, we look at different standings. We also show that different factor activities in the plaque was reduced in the patient with ventricular staining. So this clearly shows us a systemic effect of the treatment. Therefore, we further expand this systemic therapy concept into HDR. And as we all know, HDR has many biological effects. Most important and probably most studied one is the ability to enhance the reverse production transport. It also has other effects such as antioxidant. It's also anti-inflammatory, it's potential body, prophylactic. All of these contribute to the anti-thrombotic effect of HDL. High HDL, and we know very well from every 2 cycles of LDL, there's an inverse relationship between coronary artery risk and the HDL level. In animal study, the transgenic overexpression of APOA1 in mice significantly reduced atherosclerosis. This is the proof of concept that the APOA1 in HDL can reduce atherosclerosis. So all laboratory in the past 10 years has been studied very extensively on this mutant form of APOA1. So APOA1. This mutation is the pole mutation with an arginine substitute cysteine at position 173. The human carrier of this mutation was identified in the early 80s. This patient was born in this hospital in Italy. Carriers of heterozygous for mutant allele. They are descendants of this two person born in 1780. The carrier has very low HDL in the APOA1. They have no classic disease. As a matter of fact, they have a form of visual longevity. So we first look into the impact of recombinant APOA1 Milano. In the femoral neurohippocampal formation in the low injury model in hypercholesterolemia rabbit. The rabbit was treated with this recombinant APOA1 for 10 days before and after the injury. As you can see, intimal formation is significantly reduced in the treated group. And this treatment has no effect on serum cholesterol. On the right is the representative pictures of sections. We further move into a small animal, which is hypercholesterolemia, APOE knockout mice. And this is a picture of the macrophage staining from the rabbit experiment. The macrophage immunoactivity also significantly reduced, as shown on the right. This extensive staining in the control rabbit. Staining in the treated group. now the kingdom want to sacrifice with him, twice. In this study, we introduce and reject this covenant contract, like every other day for 5 years. The third group, as you can see, there's a significant progression of Apostles' verses from 23 to 25 weeks. The treatment, the progression of Apostles' verses is significantly reduced. If we follow the dose, we can even see a reduction of the Apostles' verses. Our graph here shows us the control animal in 25 weeks, which is taking the flag in the aorta. And the middle panel shows the mouse treated with Ebola for 5 weeks. There's a less development of osteosclerosis. And the lower panel shows the aorta from a mouse being treated with a high dose Ebola. And this treatment also significantly reduced the macrophage infiltration, and the macrophage infiltration can be further reduced in the high dose animal. This picture shows the macrophage reactivity in the control mouse, and in the A1 treated mouse, there's very few macrophage infiltration. So it's a DKNY expression in the aorta sample. We ask the next question, whether a single high dose of APOA1, what would that do? So we did an experiment, we injected a very high dose, 400 mg per kilo, of the recovering APOA1 in mice, and we sacrificed mice 40 hours later. We didn't expect to see any change in the size of the beam, we didn't. But we do observe a significant reduction of lipid content in the plasma. See from the graph here, the APOA1 treated group is very little less than you. And the center panel is the animal treated with the carrier, and very similar to the buffer treated group. The macrophage infiltration was also significantly reduced with the single high dose injection of APOA1. Again, since we know APOA1 Milano has this effect, we also look into the alternative way to deliver this protein in vivo. Together with the challenging Pseudo Hope under the sponsorship of an NIH grant, we designed gene therapy to deliver this. This is very familiar data, and we have two serotypes of therapy, immunosuppressive virus that can deliver this protein. Both serotypes have the same effect, significantly reduce the osteosclerosis in the hypoplastic mice. Therefore, we do believe HDL-based therapy for vascular disease will be the next frontier for the vascular disease. There's many ways to manipulate HDL. I've shown data to you, which is the carbon HDL in the A1 Milan. We also study this APOA1 mimetic peptides, and UCLA group also are very interested in this approach. We look into the effect of this pipeline in the thin graph isosperm model. Our preliminary data also shows the risk reduction of the thin graph isosperm. I also show you our preliminary data with our gene therapy. There are other ways to manipulate HDL level, such as inhibition, and also in the LXR mechanism. Related antioxidants. So we have come a long way, and last week in JAMA, Dr. Nissen group reported the first study of APOA1 Milano clinical study. And they recruited a patient with acute coronary syndrome, they did a baseline angiogram, and the patient was weakly infected with for 5 weeks, and they repeat the angiogram APN after 6 weeks, and they use fibers to assess the osteoma. As you can see on this representative pictures, there's a significant reduction of the osteoma area from 8.1 m² to 5.35 m². This picture shows a very promising and opens the door for the future HDR-based therapy. Therefore, it's long time, we do believe when we treat patients, we not only should have room for the lumen, but we also specify the donors, and that is the living core. Thank you very much.